Hari Om friends, welcome once again to my Sanatan Duniya channel, your spiritual home. In this video, I shall be giving my commentary upon verses 1 to 8 of the 4th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita. For those of you who have not yet watched the commentaries on the previous verses of the Gita, I suggest you go ahead and watch these videos before proceeding further with this video. These videos are available in the playlist titled Bhagavad Gita Commentary, all 18 chapters. Before I go ahead and give the commentary upon these verses of the 4th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, I have a small request to make. If you have not already subscribed to my channel, then I suggest you do so that you may be updated about forthcoming videos uploaded to this channel. So let's move on. The first to third slokas of the 4th chapter of the Gita are as follows. The Blessed Lord said, I instructed this imperishable science of yoga to the sun god Vivasvan, and Vivasvan instructed it to Manu, the father of mankind, and Manu in turn instructed it to Ikshvaku. This supreme science was thus received through the chain of disciplic succession, and the saintly kings understood it in that way. But in course of time, the succession was broken, and therefore the science as it is appears to be lost. That very ancient science of the relationship with the Supreme is today told by me to you, because you are my devotee as well as my friend. Therefore, you can understand the transcendental mystery of this science. The commentary of the mentioned three slokas is as follows. True knowledge is timeless, and from time to time this knowledge gets presented in different forms appropriate for that time. Here we find Bhagavan saying that he had instructed this science to the sun god Vivasvan in the beginning, who in turn instructed it to Manu, the lawgiver of mankind, who in turn instructed it to Ikshvaku. Brahma Vidya is the king of education. It is the highest science, and it is the science of the self. The self is the basis of the whole creation at the macrocosmic level, and it is also you and me at the microcosmic level. In fact, in the whole of creation, it is this self alone which exists as the only living entity. All names and forms in this creation are just inert and insentient, and they are not the living entity. It is the Supreme Self alone which exists in the whole of creation, one without a second. Brahma Vidya is the science of the self and all that is related to the self, nature and life in creation. It is a universal science and encompasses all religious and social denominations of all societies of past, present and future. The principles of this science remaining the same, different spiritual leaders in different ages tend to present this science in an artistic way, each presenting this science to the best of his knowledge and abilities. Since this science is presented differently by different spiritual figures, what happens is that over a very long period of time, when this science is handed down from one generation to the other, this science tends to get lost owing to misinterpretation and changing of hands. An example may be given here to explain how this science gets lost when it is passed from one generation of people to another. When we were small children, all of us must have played a game in which we all sit in a line or maybe in a circle, and a word is uttered in the ear of the person sitting in the front. This child then utters the word heard by him to the child sitting next to him. Then that child in turn utters the same word that he heard to the child sitting next to him. In this way, the same word which was uttered in the ear of the first child is uttered into the ears of the subsequent children one by one. Finally, by the time that word is uttered in the ear of the last child, who may be the 20th or 25th child, the word is then said aloud by the last child. And yes, you must have understood by now. The word uttered by the last child when spoken aloud tends to be a complete distortion of the word uttered in the ear of the first child. This above example is more than enough to clearly explain what Bhagwan is saying in these first three verses of the fourth chapter here. When knowledge as deep as Brahma Vidya or the science of the self is handed down from one generation to another, there is bound to be some misinterpretation and distortion of that very sacred knowledge. So here we find Bhagwan telling Arjuna in the third verse that it is the same ancient science of yoga which Bhagwan taught to the sun god that Bhagwan is now teaching again to Arjuna. The words may be a little different, but what helps to revive the science of the self from age to age is the fact that the spirit of Brahma Vidya never changes and their principles remain the same throughout the three periods of time. Now I shall move on to verses 4 to 8. The 4th to 8th verses of the 4th chapter of the Gita are as follows. Arjuna said, "The sun god Vivaswan is senior by birth to you. How am I to understand that in the beginning you instructed this science to him?" The blessed Lord said, "Many, many births both you and I have passed. I can remember all of them, but you cannot, O subduer of the enemy. Although I am unborn and my transcendental body never deteriorates, and although I am the Lord of all sentient beings, I still appear in every millennium in my original transcendental form. Whenever and wherever there is a decline in religious practice or descent of Bharata and a predominant rise of irreligion, at that time I descend myself. In order to deliver the pious and to annihilate the miscreants, as well as to re-establish the principles of religion, I advent myself millennium after millennium." The commentary of the mentioned five slokas is as follows. In the next two verses here, Arjuna seems a little confused. He is unable to understand how the same Lord Krishna who is speaking this knowledge to him just then could have spoken the same knowledge millions of years ago to the sun god. This perplexes Arjuna and hence he is asking this question here. Bhagwan replies by explaining the basis of the law of reincarnation. Bhagwan explains that both Arjuna and Bhagwan himself have had many births in the past. Only thing being that the Lord remembers all his past lives, whereas Arjuna, being a conditioned soul, is not able to recall his past lives. This sloka in the Gita is often quoted by we people of Sanatan Dharma as the proof of the doctrine of reincarnation. In fact, our Sanatan Dharma has always believed in reincarnation, and this doctrine remains one of the cornerstones of the foundation of our eternal religion. Among all human beings, there are basically only two types of souls based on their degree of knowledge. They are number one, conditioned souls, and number two, realized souls. Conditioned souls refer to all souls who are under the spell of the Lord's Maya and hence are ignorant of the truth. Conditioning makes a soul mistake the body to be the self and makes the embodied soul undergo a lot of suffering in creation. A conditioned soul is usually attracted to the sense objects and tends to live a materialistic life as it thinks that the objects it enjoys are eternal. A conditioned soul does not have memory of past lives, and this is indeed a blessing for all we conditioned souls. Just imagine how much more miserable we would have been if we had knowledge of our past lives. Thank God we don't. However, when a conditioned soul attains liberation or self-realization, then along with knowledge of the truth of the self and along with other major and minor occult powers, the realized soul also revives his memory of his past lives and can recall them at will. A realized soul is free from the effects of the Lord's Maya and lives a very detached and simple life, thinking and working for God alone and being very selfless. So therefore, Lord Krishna, being the origin of the whole creation and the creator of the conditioned and other creatures, will obviously be able to recall all his past lives. He reveals to Arjuna that he can remember all his past lives, including the remote one in which he had instructed this science to the sun god. Lord Krishna is the 8th avatar of Lord Vishnu, as most of us must be knowing, and the glory of his divine birth and activities is being mentioned in the following 3 verses. In the next 3 verses, Lord Krishna is saying that whenever there is a decline in religious principles and an uprising of irreligion, then he reincarnates for 3 reasons. Number 1, to protect the virtues of good people. Number 2, to annihilate the evil people. And number 3, to re-establish the principles of religion. Only an incarnation of the spirit who fulfills these 3 objectives in his life can be considered to be an incarnation of Lord Vishnu. The Puranas are filled with true life stories of the avatars of Vishnu who lived in the past and recent past and forthcoming avatars of Vishnu as well. Lord Vishnu is the one out of whom the whole creation has emerged. It is he who initially established the basic principles of religion which have to be followed by humanity. And whenever he finds that the principles of religion have been violated to a great degree or to a degree to which human efforts cannot be applied to rectify the situation, then he incarnates to fulfill the above 3 mentioned objectives. An example may be given to illustrate this point better. It is the government that frames the different laws of the country from time to time. If it is found that there are many people who are violating the law, then it is the government's duty and responsibility to punish all those who violate the law. Similarly, it is God who frames the laws of creation and the principles of dharma, and it is God alone who fulfills his responsibility of rewarding the virtuous and punishing the evildoers. So friends, here ends the commentary on the 1st to 8th verses of the 4th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita. Stay tuned for more commentaries on the following verses of the Gita and keep checking this channel for updates to this playlist titled Bhagavad Gita Commentary All 18 Chapters. And also do watch the other videos available in this channel so that you can enhance your knowledge of the eternal religion or Sanatan Dharma. And in case you have not already subscribed to my channel, then I suggest you do so that you may be updated about forthcoming videos uploaded to this channel. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great time ahead. Hari Om.